Remembered a joke. What to tell Dan. Right. I think it's really funny. All right. There's a penguin.
Red all over. Like a newspaper.
No. All right. And he's driving his car out in the desert. And it breaks down. So, thankfully, there's a garage just where he's broken down.
Yeah.
So he goes into the garage. And he says, I don't know what's happened to my car. It's just stopped working.
Yeah.
He says, all right, well, I can't get to it for a couple of hours, but, you know, I can have a look at it in a bit. He said, oh, that's fine. I'm not in a rush. Is there anything I can do, like, while I'm waiting? He said, yeah, actually, there's an ice cream parlour next door. He says, all right, I'll go in there for a bit. So, he goes in. He goes into the ice cream parlour. And he says, oh, I'll have a raspberry ripple. No problem. There you go. So he sits down with his ice cream. And because he's a penguin, he's not very good at eating. He's really messy. So he gets this, you know,
minute and a half
ice cream all over his mouth.
Yeah.
Anyway, you know, he's in there for a couple of hours and he goes back to the garage and he walks in and the mechanic says, oh, looks like you've blown a seal.
I knew he was going to do that. I just worked it out goes, then.
No, it's just ice cream.
I knew it. Yeah, no, I've heard that before.
It's good, isn't it?
Yeah. Can't believe I didn't see that coming. I have heard that before.
So funny.
Are we in focus? Good morning. Hi, everyone. I'll give you my breakfast. Good morning. So, last night, we went to the theatre. Me and Gemma. I haven't seen for ages. We went to see Adam Kay. Do you remember that guy? He brought a book out a few years ago. I never read it, but I had the audio book. And it was called This Is Going to Hurt. And it was turned into a BBC drama with Ben Wishwilshaw, the guy from 007. And was he called Q, I think? I think he was Q. Anyway, so we went to see the actual doctor, Adam Kay. And I think this is his fourth book. And it totally wasn't what I was expecting at all. I thought it was going to be sort of stand-up. I don't know, stand-up show kind of thing. Because he was a doctor for, well, he was in medical school for 7 years. And he was a doctor for 6 years. 6 years, 7 years, whatever. And then he quit. It was too stressful for him. Nah. And basically this show was him in a funny way, but also in a very serious way, telling us to respect the NHS a bit more, and doctors and nurses. Like, he was just reading passages from his book, which is very funny, but also very poignant in places. Like, he said, one doctor, is it every week? Yeah. Every week a doctor commits suicide. Come on. And every day a nurse commits suicide. Like, those are statistics. Jesus, like, who knew? So, yeah, a lot of talk about that. But really funny in places, because obviously it was, like, reminiscing about all the funny anecdotes he had from working as a doctor and training and whatever. So yeah, it was just, and it was an hour and 15 minutes long, which was fine. It didn't feel like an hour and 15 minutes. It felt like half an hour. It was great. But anyway, we had a great evening. We went for something to eat before. Come on then. Gemma wanted to go to Thai place, and I had a look at the menu and I was like, oh, there's so much stuff for one. I'd want to get like a tapas. But then at the same time, I won't bloody eat any of it. So what's the point, you know? So we ended up going to a Greek gyros sort of place. Love that. It's all protein. And I took a picture of my food before I ate it. And it was absolutely delicious. But look at the after photo. Like, I was absolutely pogged. So, delicious as it was, complete waste of money. So, I've learned not to bother going out to eat, basically. Strawberry and banana podge. Delicious. Dropped Dot off at school this morning. She was fine. She wasn't... Oh, my God. The teacher sent a message home Thursday night saying that somebody in the class had got nits. Like, we're less than 2 weeks in. How can this be happening? Absolutely mortified. Like, this is really why I don't cut children's hair at work. Like, I will if I'm absolutely desperate for a bit of cash that day. But I don't like doing it. Because you've got to, like, fully inspect their head before you cut them. And that takes time. And then, obviously, they wriggle and they talk. Ugh, a nightmare. So, anyway, I keep checking her. She's fine. I bought everything under the sun that I can to try and prevent and treat. So, got a special knit comb, nitty gritty comb, I think it's called. Hedrin. What do you call it? Stuff you put on the hair after you've shampooed it. To prevent. Repel. What are you doing? Repel. Yeah. But then, so I was out last night, so I said to Dan, I said, oh, make sure you put this treatment stuff on after you've washed her hair. And I got Dot up this morning, looked at her, and she was cut, like, caked. And these little black, gritty stuff, like, I'll put a picture in. Black, gritty bit stuff, so I don't know if Dan's, like, put too much on or... It's put like a residue on her hair or something. I don't know. It's matter. It's yummy. So anyway, I dropped her off. She was absolutely fine. Then I walked down to Morrison's because we actually went food shopping yesterday. But we didn't. We just went to Home Bargains. So come on then. So we didn't get any like meat to make meals, you know. So I've just gone down to Morrison's and bought some mince. And some snacks for you, because we haven't got any snacks, have we? Yeah. But, yeah. What else is happening in my life? I should talk 6 minutes and not say on. Oh, my God, last night. Oh, God. What a nightmare. So, it was quite late by the time we got back to Huddersfield. So, we went to Leeds. And Gemma dropped me off at the bus station. And as soon as I got out of the car, shut the door, she whizzed off. And I patted myself down for my phone and it wasn't there. I've got dungarees on for some reason. Yeah. That are far too big for me. And I knew I'd left my phone in Gemma's car. And I was like, shit, what am I going to do? Then I remembered I'd actually put my bank card in my top pocket. Because we've been out to Home Bargains shopping earlier in the day. So I was like, right, okay, I can use my bank card, I'll walk down to Sainsbury's and get some cash out, then I'll get a taxi to Gemma's house, get my phone back, come on, and then I'll get a taxi or bus back to home. I was like, oh my God, this is going to cost me like 30 quid. Anyway, found my bank card in my pocket, walked up the road and round the corner to walk down to Sainsbury's, and guess who is at the traffic light still waiting? Gemma. So So I ran as fast as I could because I knew she'd like set off as soon as this light had turned green. Yeah. Ran down this road going, Gemma, Gemma! Like trying to make myself as big as possible so she could see who's this lunatic running towards my car. Anyway, yeah, found my phone. It slipped out of my pocket. It had gone under the car seat. Oh my God. There you go. Like, I need my phone all day. Like, one, I need it for my alarm in the morning. Two, I need it in case anybody rings me from school if anything's happened to Dot. And three, obviously, I'm a stay-at-home mum. I'm addicted to TikTok. I need my phone. I'm not a stay-at-home mum. I'm a working mum. Part-time, it would seem. Work is absolutely shocking at the moment. Like, I had cancellation last week. And that was like a big blow because it was quite a lot of money. And it was the one client I had that day as well, like a big colour job. So that was rude. Thankfully, I was really busy on Saturday. So, but yeah, I only worked Saturday last week. How bad is that? Baby. Oh no, I fitted some extensions as well for somebody. But I did that at home because I was like, we're going to be here all day. I want to be comfortable, you know. Oh my God, that was another thing. Why haven't I been vlogging anything? I'm so useless. I'll just sit here and talk to you. So this client, she came over to my house with her dog. It's a little Dachshund sausage dog. And unfortunately, it's quite common for Dachshunds to have back problems, like the spines or whatever. Anyway, I'm not sure exactly what happened, but this Dachshund had something happen to its back, like a slip disc or something, and it paralysed this poor dog. I don't know, maybe a couple of months ago, maybe 6 weeks ago. And this dog had sort of managed to get the use of its front legs back, but it was still dragging its back legs. Well, I tell you what, this dog got into my house and obviously I'm like fussing this gorgeous little doggy and it started trying to like pull itself towards me. And then it was like sniffing around. Obviously Bernie drops a lot of food on the floor. So this dog was sniffing all around Bernie's high chair and like pulling herself along a bit more. And then I don't know how it happened, but this dog managed to like follow me across the room, like really, really stumbling and whatever. But it bloody walked, this dog. Anyway, I'm not kidding you. By the end of the day, because she was here 5 hours getting her hair done, this dog was bloody walking, like wobbly, but it was like kind of hop, skipping, jumping towards me. And it was like woofing at me, pick me up, I want a cuddle, you know. And this client was in tears. She was like, she's never like this with anybody. I've never seen her walk since the operation. Like, she just kind of got healed, this dog, from, I guess, being out of the house. Because obviously she's not been taking this dog for walks or anything. Come on then. But because she was in, like, a new house, with, you know, loads of interesting smells and somebody new to pay attention to her and fuss over her, it kind of got her going again. And she absolutely loved me, this dog. And she said, this dog is not like this with anybody. She only likes me. So I felt very special. I felt, you know, wow, I've really made a bit of a difference here to this dog, which was lovely. Yeah. Got magic healing powers for puppies. Don't you dare bite my thumb. You've got your 9 month review, haven't you? Next week with Daddy. Mummy's at work. But then Daddy might be going to Ireland, so we might have to reschedule it. This baby's got no interest in crawling still. She'll like, if she's sat on a bum and she sees something she wants, she'll like reach forward for it and go onto her belly, but that's it. And you kind of commando yourself backwards, don't you? And you can turn, but you won't crawl. We need to have some good practice at that today, Burns. I'm tired. It is nearly nap time, to be fair. Yeah, I dragged you down to Morrison's, didn't I? Instead of coming home for breakfast. Having a late breakfast. But it's good because it means...
Yeah.
You'll have a nice big long nap and Mummy can get all the washing put away. All Dot's uniform steamed. Do the washing up. Sort the bloody fridge out. Oh, God. Went food shopping last week and we just threw everything in the fridge. I didn't, like, nicely organise it, so it looks horrendous. I have no idea what's in there. So, that's our jobs for today. Right, last one, and then you can have your little cracker thing that you were snacking on. Yeah. One more? Good girl. Guess who's back, 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 back again. Sippy cup. Now then. This is very difficult, Bernie, but have a go. It's very difficult. Are you doing it? Looks like you are. Did you get something? Did you do it? Just bought this down at Morrison's. Here's what we use with Dot. That's it, clever girl. Are you doing it? Girl. Oh, no, you're not, because Mummy's not taking the... Oh, I'm so stupid. Wait, give it me. I've washed it, but I've not taken the plastic off. So you won't be able to get any juice. Look how stupid I am. I was sucking it, and I was like, fucking hell, that's hard. Hang on, Bernie. Let's try now. That's it. Try now. Try. I fucked it up. Fuck. Come on. Water. I'm so stupid. I've ruined it. Bernie, gonna have some water. Water. Well, I'll leave it there for you. Is it coming now? Is it coming? Bernie. 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 No. Come on then. Come on then. It's not for chewing. Well, you've got water all around your mouth, so I'm guessing it's working. There you go. You like these, don't you? Yes. Woo! Bernadette! You burper gerper. Okay. Snacks and juice. Well, water. Good girl.
They took some honey and plenty of money wrapped up in a £5 note. But I looked up to the stars. Above, and sang to a small guitar. Sweet pussy, oh pussy, my rocket. Beautiful pussy, you are. What a beautiful pussy you are.
Well done.
Eek.
Come
here. Okay. Pussy said to the owl, you elegant fowl, darling.
It's going to be a very long story, this, Dorothy. Come on.
Okay. I wasn't reading.
Right, she's not reading it nicely anymore, Dorothy. Right, well, come on, read it nicely.
Okay. That rings. But what should we do? Ring up.
All right.
That's why I don't know it. They sailed away for a year and a day to land with a bong tree. Go! Dear, It's not that pretty.
Go on.
Can you have a boy water?
I'm waiting for you to sing.
Okay. That's
and the...
I'm burying a word of Piggy Wiggs stud with a ring at the end of his nose. His nose with a ring at the end of his nose.
Very nice.
Are you willing to sell for one chewing your rings and for Piggy? I will. So they took it away and were married next time by the turkey who lives on the hill.
Lovely. Really good.
Why does he have a bow tie on it?
He's just got married.
Oh, yeah.
He's got to look the part.
Why?
Because you've got to look your best on your wedding day.
But why does it look...
Come on, last bit now.
Okay. They dined on mint and slices of... Can I do it funny when you've gone?
Yeah.
Good. They dined on mint and slices of quince, which they ate with a runcible spoon. And hand in hand hand in hand in the edge of the sand, they danced by the light of the moon. The moon! They danced by the light of the moon.
Very good. Got there in the end. 6 minutes, 7.5 minutes that took.
Oh, wow. It's like a meatloaf song, that.
Good morning. Look how, like, gingery my hair's gone. What's that about? What is it? It's Thursday today. And Dots at school, Bernie's at the Childminders. And I don't know if I've already talked about this. Maybe I did, I can't remember. But I do my weight loss injections on a Sunday night. And I'd gone to see Adam Kay at the theatre. Got into bed, I was all snuggled, it was really late, and I was like, oh shit, I've forgotten to do my injection. So get out of bed, go downstairs, get my little pen, and I put a needle on it. And I think it's a bit like a diabetic pen where you twist it and it gives you like a measured amount. And I started twisting it and it wouldn't twist, and I was like, oh bollocks, maybe it's like jammed or whatever. So I go to Dan and I'm like, Dan, can you twist this? I can't do it. He's like, no, that's not twisting. And then I realised it's because I've done it. I've finished the pen. Like, you get 4 injections in one pen. So 4 weeks in one pen. And you get a little bit extra fluid to, like, test that it's working. So you do like a primer shot almost. So you twist it a little bit and you squeeze it so a little bit of fluid comes out. So that's like your primer. That's all got left in there. And I was like, shit. So I can't inject. Right, got straight on my phone, ordered the next pen. And it's like, oh yeah, next day delivery, you've been approved, no problem. So that was Sunday night. It's now fucking Thursday and it's still not here. So this is like my 4th day of no medication in my body. So obviously I haven't lost a pound this week because I think because I'm eating. I don't know if I'm eating more, but I'm definitely not eating the right stuff. It's like we had smash burgers last night, and I had a burger, I ate the whole thing, and 2 sweet potato fries. So not a lot, but my body wasn't like, salad, vegetables. Does that make sense? Anyway, I've had a notification that it's coming today in the next hour or two, hopefully. So this is where the dilemma is.
when I do my, I used to do my injection on Monday. And by Wednesday, so Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I would feel fucking terrible. I'd be throwing up in the morning. Awful. I felt awful. So if I inject today, Thursday, that's Thursday, Friday, Saturday, it's that fucking wedding. I've got a wedding to do. So I cannot be sick and feel like shit. Now here's the next dilemma. This injection is the next dose up. So it's stronger. Here's the next dilemma. I've got 4 days of having nothing in my system. So I really don't know what to do, because if I wasn't doing this wedding, I'd just take it, suck it up, feel like shit, you know? And it wouldn't matter. But I cannot have any side effects at this fucking wedding. Like, the side effects. Oh. Now, I've been reading up about it, and apparently where on your body you inject can really affect how you are. So people seem to get the most nausea from injecting in the stomach. They seem to get the most appetite suppression from the thigh, but they get the least side effects if you inject in your arm. So I just don't know what to do, because obviously if I don't inject, if I wait until after the wedding and then inject, that's like 6-7 days nearly of no medication in my body. So when I get that full whack of 7.5 milligram, am I going to be on my arse, feeling sick or whatever? But I don't know. I don't know what to do. I'm proper in turmoil. Because also as well, this medication can really make you go to the toilet. And can you imagine if I have to be like shitting myself at this bride's... It's not funny. I don't know what to do. Help me. You can't, because this will have gone up after the fact. Oh, it's freezing. It's supposed to be 18 degrees today. I've sent Dot to school in like a little school dress, little skirt and t-shirt, and it's fucking freezing. And I need to tidy up. I said I was just going to lie down for half an hour, chill. And it's been an hour. Right, come on, let's get on with it. Fucking DPD man fucked off before I could get to the door. I'm so annoyed. So at least I guess that answers my choice about whether I'm going to be taking the injection before that wedding. I'm just going to have to do it after the wedding. I'm not going to risk it. Like, it would just, I just don't, I can't risk it. I don't want to cause any bother on the wedding day. I need to be the one that's cool and calm and chilled, you know. I can't believe it. It's supposed, like, they can't leave medication to be delivered in a safe place, because obviously somebody else could find it, you know, and use it. So yeah, but what's worrying me is, like, it has to be kept in the fridge, this medication, and they send it in like freezer bags, you know, it's got ice all wrapped around it and everything. But yeah, this is what happened last time. It's this new company I'm using to get it from, New Pharmacy. It happened last time. It was the I don't know. Might go back to the original company I was using, because I have not had a delivery on the day they've promised. since I've started using them. So anyway, just been sat here. I've done myself a lovely big Shein haul. I think I've only ever bought like a couple of t-shirts off Shein before. I've used Temu a couple of times, I think, as well. But I'd seen this, what was it now? I think it was a jumper. It was a jumper that was black. And it had like really sort of gothy moths and moons and Halloween-y vibes kind of thing. And it was only like £6. And I was like, oh, yeah, I think I need to get that. Well, of course, it suggests other things you may like. So I've ended up ordering about £60 worth of stuff from Shein. It's not going to come for a couple of weeks, obviously, because, you know. But yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I can't wait to see everything I've ordered. I didn't get anything for Dorothy. I got a cute little pumpkin hat for Bernalyn, who Dorothy started calling Bunny again, which I'm really happy about because I love that for a nickname for her. I ordered a load of posters as well for the kitchen because now that we've got rid of the glass cabinet, there's like this big blank wall with one picture frame on it and it just looks really boring. And all these prints were like £1, so I bought a lot of those as well. Obviously, we'll do a haul for you when it arrives, but yeah. When I was changing my bedding and sorting out the laundry basket, I stuck on one of my favourite albums from when I was a 14-year-old mosher. Papa Roach Infest. What an album. Like, I actually went to see Papa Roach in Manchester at the Manchester Apollo Theatre. It was a theatre. Was it? Is it? Oh, it felt like a theatre when I was there. Amazing venue. And we were up on the Royal Circle balcony, front row. Oh my God. I always cry at music. I don't know why, but I just remember. Oh, Alien Ant Farm with the warm up. And they were actually better than Papa Roach. But anyway, when they came on and did the opening song, which was Infest, the opening song of the album, because it was that tour of that album. I just died. I just honestly, like, I was so embarrassed because I was, like, the only girl with all these gorgeous, they weren't gorgeous, probably spotty, horrible teenage boys, gorgeous lads. I was the only girl there. And I was, like, trying to hide that I was, like, overwhelmed with joy and couldn't believe that I was there watching Papa Roach. Like, oh, amazing. So, yeah, I've just been singing at the top of my voice, a bit of Papa Roach. It's because of Lisa, her son started listening to a band called, what did she say, Falling in Reverse, I think. I've never heard of them, but she's obsessed with their orchestral cover of songs just totally gone from my mind. Last Resort. I've just been singing it. It's like an orchestral version of it. And it's okay. I'm not sure how much I like the singer's voice. He's got a very good voice. But whoever's produced it and mixed it has put so much auto-tune on it. It's ruined it for me. I can't stand auto-tune. There's a time and a place for it. And that is not the place for it in this song. But he has got a lovely voice. A really good, really healthy distortion when he's doing his screaming stuff, but I just don't like auto-tune on ballads, shall I say. But it's a great music video, really beautiful. But I don't know what my problem is. Like, my favourite sort of rock, if you want to call it rock, I don't know what the genre is, but like the orchestral covers that I like the most is The Sound of Silence by Disturbed. I think that is one of the greatest remastered, reimagined versions ever. But I can't stand his voice. The Disturbed. He's, again, he's got an amazing voice, but he puts on this tone that I can't bear. In the naked light I saw. Why are you doing that? Why are you doing that? Hate it. It's this sort of a Cher. You know Cher? That kind of a sound. And you don't need to do it. Your voice is fantastic. Why are you putting it on? I hate it. It really is like my word. It's kind of that throaty, toady. Why are you doing it? Anyway, I love that version of the song. It's better than the original. But I just wish he didn't sing it the way he does in certain parts. Why am I rambling about this? I'll tell you why. Because I've got all this free time in the world. The house is tidy. Like, I'm just having a chill. And it's really, really nice. I shouldn't be, actually. I need to be sterilising and packing up all my stuff for this wedding on Saturday. I like to be organised. So, yeah, I might go do that, actually, and stop rambling. Hello, it's me again. I've moved from the bed to the sofa. I've got this app. School app. I'm going to put you down. Dorothy's school have got this app where they can send you like videos and photographs of what the class have been up to and whatever. The teacher has just sent a video about phonics. Hello, these are the phonics we need you to be practicing this week. S for snake. N for net. What was the other one? The tower. And it's really important that you practice these at home with your children. We're going to be sending phonics books home. So it's really important when we start to teach your children to read. I'm like, hang on a fucking minute. Teach my child to read? Done it, mate. Completed it, mate. I don't know what to do. Like, I wanted to do homework, but my kid can read. And I'm not bragging at all. Please don't think I'm bragging. Dot is fluent. Like, she can read anything. And if she can't read it, I've always said she has a bloody good go of it. It's like we go to a memorial park. She calls it a memorial park because that's what she's read as we've gone past it in the car. Oh, look, Mummy, it's the memorial park. Like, should I be saying something tomorrow when I go and pick her up from school? Like, hello, you're probably aware my child can read properly, if any of you have ever actually sat down with her for a second. Could she have some maths homework instead? Is that weird? Like, she can't write. She cannot write. She can follow the word, like, you know, dot to dots. I don't know what to do. I feel really... I didn't realise this was going to be a... It's not a problem, is it? You know what I mean? Like, I'm hoping that when she gets her homework, it's... If it's homework, I don't know if your class is that. Like, are they going to give her something a bit more challenging, like some worksheets for her to practice her writing or something? Because if I ask her to do stuff, she'll do it, but she'll get bored and, like, she won't finish it. But if it's for school, I think she'd really want to do it. I don't have a printer, so it's not like I can print out some stuff for her to do herself. I don't know. Am I taking my kids' education into my own hands here? Do you know what I mean? Like, she doesn't need to be taught how to read. She can read.
very weird. I don't know what to do. Fucking hell. I might message my friend. She's a junior school teacher. I think she teaches reception, actually. I might say, yo, she could do a phonics. What should I be doing next? Kind of thing. I don't know what to do. Isn't it stupid? She's a special girl, that Dorothy.
Good morning. I never look exactly the same. I've just cleaned all my makeup brushes. I have so many. Like, that was one set. There's some more. Here's some more. So I've just washed them all. And now I'm going to dry and reshape them all. Honestly. Like, I know I'm getting paid for this, but so much prep goes into it, doesn't it? I've got to, like, sterilise all my powders as well. God, it's such a fanny ache, isn't it? I chickened out of mentioning homework to Dot's teacher this morning when I dropped her off. I don't know why. I don't want to be that parent, you know. My child's far too clever for the homework you're saying. Oh, I feel like a right knob. Oh well, what can I do? See how she gets on. Like, I don't know. Am I expecting too much? That little girl that was on about, the one that cries all the time. And where's nappies that I mentioned way back in this vlog. She arrived today. I think she was about the third one there. We're always first. I don't know why. I think it's because I've got a pram. And like, how easy is it going to be for me to get there? Is Doc going to want to walk quick today, you know? I was set off like 20 minutes before. It's only a 10 minute walk, but I was set off 20 minutes before. Anyway, this girl was there and Dot went, oh, it's whatever's her name. I was like, oh yeah, so it is. And she was like, just great, she's here today, you know. So Dorothy said she doesn't speak. Like, non-verbal. Dorothy didn't say non-verbal, but oh, she doesn't talk. She just cries. Like, I was trying to listen to see if she was, like, talking to her mum at all. And she was trying to say something, but I couldn't make out what the words were, you know? I don't know. I just, part of me's like, have I sent her to the right school? I don't know. It is a bit rough, like, because it is near quite a big council estate. So there are a lot of kids, you know. It's not the kids, it's the parents. It's the parents that I see rocking up with these kids. And I just think, oh God, what kind of a family? Oh, am I awful? I am awful, aren't I? I am judging. Sorry. I don't know. I just think back to, like, when I was a kid. Like, there were a few rough kids that were in my class at junior school, but I was never interested in playing with them. Like, I knew that they were a bit rough and a bit dirty and, like, I don't want to play with them. Like, I never asked if I could go to any of these kids' houses, you know? So I'm hoping Dot's going to be like that. But then I was like, well, you know, are any of these kids all right? Am I rough? Is this it? Am I rough? Oh, my God. Maybe I am.
Maybe I'm deluded. Oh dear. Right, those brushes, I need to blow dry them now. And then start cleaning all the palettes and stuff. I need to find my sterilising spray again.
Unattractive angles are the thing for this vlog. Remember I ordered some Shein stuff yesterday? Some of it's here. So that's fun. Yeah. What do you do with a 9-month-old that can't crawl? And entertain itself. Oh, great. What the hell is that? That's it, two things. It says Merry Christmas. What the hell is it? Alright, a t-shirt, I believe. Let's see. Yeah. Are you a Halloween? Ooh! Okay, I got this for singing him. It's a big t-shirt dress that's got tassels on the end of it. I like stuff that moves when I'm dancing about. Oh, cute. And it's got a little pocket, which is handy. That's nice. And then this is a poster that I got for the kitchen, but I wanted to frame them. But I don't... This looks pretty massive. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to afford a frame this big. Yeah. Oh, right. It is a poster. It's like... it kind of feels like a tablecloth material. In like a wipeable fabric kind of thing. It's... Oh, okay. It just says, Bon Appetit. Bon Appetit. That's all right. It's really weird. Weird fabric. Or material, I should say. Uh-huh. But that's cool. I think that was only like £2. A baby? You little baby? I'll go pick your sister up soon, haven't we? Who's on the phone? Policeman. She loves that t-shirt. She loves that phone. It's like a vintage toy. Vintage toys are the best, aren't they? Are you stamping on the baby? Are you stamping on the baby? He's stamping on the baby. You try to see it. Yeah. Boing, 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 boing. Bouncing baby. Doggy, woof woof, woof woof. I can't remember if I told you. I took him up to, took Dot to school. Bloody hell, Bernie! Be careful. You're gonna give yourself whiplash. And I took Bernie up because they said that you can. What did they say you could do? Take siblings to have a photograph with them, even if they're not at the school. So that was fun, and the photos were adorable. So, yeah, you are so cute. You wore an actual outfit, not pajamas for once. That photo there, that Dot's nursery photo, it's about £30 for one photo. And I was like, oh my God, how much is it going to be for like Dot's school photo and then a photo of baby with her? And it was like a package for £30. You got about 8 photos for £30. Bang him.
Well, sorry, so I'm going to start already. Okay, now. I don't think I'm ready. I can't remember.
You're a beauty.
She looks gorgeous, doesn't she?
You really are.
Oh, Pam.
Log it.
All right,
we're
all right. It's all
right.
We've got shit to do.
Who's that? It's you. Just had a 5-minute nap in the car. We're having tea. It's Sunday. I've just got back from visiting my sister in hospital. She's had a knee replacement. Went really well. She's in agony. She's had morphine, but she said it wasn't really doing anything. And she's had this... what's that? Oxy something that's really bad, you know. What's it called, Bernie? Can you remember? I can't remember. It's the one that all the Americans are addicted to. There's been loads of dramas about it. Dope Sick was one of them. What was that drug called? She's on Oxy.
Not OxyContin, but very similar.
Something like that.
Yeah.
Dan is going away to the Isle of Man. 3 weeks minimum. I can't remember if I've already said this before. We've got the last can in the shop. How is it? It's Oreo Coke Zero.
What's Oreo?
Alright. Is it like vanilla Coke?
I was going to say, it's just vanilla Coke, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's very sweet. I like vanilla Coke, but I don't think I like this.
Oh, really?
It's so sweet. Is it, or is it just me? Because I'm not used to the sweet stuff.
It's just you.
It's just me.
It's not that sweet. But I think it's a bit tasty.
Oh, yeah, my print framed it. It's good. It's alright, isn't it? £3 or whatever it was. So I'm hoping this wall is going to have some more art on it, because at the moment it's just got a like a blueprint skeleton of a 205 up there that I got done for Christmas 10 years ago. Right, are you having what? Some blueberries and yoghurt maybe?
Who?
It's baby. We're back. Into fashion, but I love the clothes she wears. Her tattoos always going right around her underwear. She don't care. Everybody wants to know her name. Like to walk out funny and she says, everyone asks me, who the hell is she? That weirdo with my colors in her hair. She was all I thought about.
Cue that last chord you played there. G. Okay. Roughly in the right key.
Dot, I really need you to help me put this washing in the washing machine, please.
I will.
Come on then. Funny joke.
I like to see it again.
Oh dear. Hi. Just dropped the girls off. Got a day to myself. Unfortunately, I have to remove all my hair extensions and retape them because they are hanging on for dear life. Absolutely horrendous. But yeah, got to do that today. That's not cool. Sorry this vlog's just been me talking at you, but that is all I've had time to do. Dan went away to the Isle of Man. I've got to do my eyelashes as well. And dye my roots. Ah! Dan went to the Isle of Man, not Ireland, on Sunday night and abandoned me. And has abandoned me, well, will be abandoning me for the next, how many weeks did he say? 3 weeks minimum. So he should be home tomorrow night. But yeah, I've been on my own all week. So I'm glad I've been at work because it's actually given me something to do. You know, speak to adults. And you guys, obviously. So yeah, that's my fun week. Oh yeah, I wanted to show you, you know, I did that Temu order. I finally got a cute little ghost ornament. I've been looking for one for ages, but I've just wanted a black and white one, not an orange one, like with any pumpkins on it or anything. And it's just too cute. So that's that. Right, finish off the vlog. And I don't know, hopefully next time you see me, I'll have some decent eyelashes and nice hair again. Alright, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.